self-representation and stress. Representing yourself is one of the most stressful matters you will ever deal with in your life, or at least representing myself is one of the most stressful, demanding, all-consuming activity I've ever done in my own time. Each time I get served, I start shaking, because it's a whole new set of allegations, it's a whole new set of trouble that I need to address and that I need to find a solution to, and I need to respond. It's a whole new hairball that has been coughed up and spat in my face of all the different allegations and embarrassments and lies and things that I've leveled against me, that to take away my freedoms, my rights as a parent. So it is very hard, it is very stressful. There's no doubt about it, but if I had a lawyer, my lawyer would take care of all these matters and be a proxy between me and the other party. And the value that a lawyer provides is really, really worth the fee. They take all the stress, they assure you, they're the only person who believe in you and are ready to support you. No matter what your situation is, and no matter what other people judge you as. Yet, so, it is always very good to get a lawyer, but if you cannot and you do not have a lawyer, then self-representation is the only other option. And during that process, it is very important that you learn to manage your stress levels, because the stress is just going to get too hard. Big, grown, huge, 6 feet plus men like crumble under the stress and they just throw their hands up and say, no, I can't do this anymore, I give up, I'm gone. And that is what exactly the other party wants you to do. They're going to stress you out, worry you, accuse you.